I'd like to show you an image that I just did. It's an image of cone, a sphere, a cube, abstract art. Abstract art is what you, excuse me, I'm going to go ahead and set this up on the side so I can explain how to do it. I'm sorry about the individual only bits. Abstract art is something that anyone can do. You can do any color that you'd like. It's unbelievable. Some people throw paint all over a canvas and it turns out really neat and they love it, and other people love it, and that's art. So abstract is more or less anything. A flower can become abstract if you make it purple, pink, or yellow, whatever. It's up to you. There's no laws in abstract art. And the only thing is just have fun, enjoy doing art, enjoy art. So, I want to show you a couple of the techniques that I used on this abstract painting. It's, first of all, I use dollar store material. Now, for right now, that's my medium. I'll graduate and get better, and I'll be able to feel more comfortable using canvas and probably oil, but for right now, I like acrylic and poster board. 50 cents, you know, all dollar store buys to begin with. You know, you don't go and get the most expensive things that you can and not get an idea of what it is that you want to do. Get some techniques and watch some videos. There's tons of videos. Artists love sharing techniques and showing other people their passion. People really, really enjoy showing their passion, as I do. So go ahead and get inexpensive things to start with, and it'll be more satisfying when you graduate. Graduate is just a term I'm using. Once you feel comfortable and to use canvas, to use oil, to use, you could still use acrylic on canvas. It'll still be just as beautiful and gorgeous. It's up to you, watercolor, whatever. But there are different types of preparations when you do use canvas. There's the prep work for the canvas itself that you have. I think it's called Gesso or Gesso. I'm really not sure. You see how, you know, knowledgeable I am about art, but I think it's called Gesso or Gesso, something like that. And you put that on the canvas before you start painting with oil. Otherwise, the oil won't adhere, and it won't last for a very long time. So, you know, get informed. Get a good idea of what it is that you want to do. If you want to do abstract, you want to do realism, then you start off with, you know, pencil drawings and paint on boards like this. Not expensive, cheap material, and get familiar with your brushes and the strokes and things that you can achieve with your brushes. So let's start off with the background. I did a background, and I was going to do a cube, a sphere, and a cone. Well, like that's I did exactly what I did eventually, but I drew it lightly. But when I did my background color, I couldn't even see what I was drawing. So I did a rough sketch after I did my background color, and I wanted a beige brown in the background and turquoise. I love turquoise, so that's what I wanted. If you have magenta walls, then you might want to do all of these in different tones of magenta, and white or black, or if you want just regular old black and white. You know, that it's up to you. It's your abstract art. It's your design, your colors. If you want blues, yellows, pinks, purple, it's up to you. Don't worry about it. It's fun. Have fun. Okay. So for the background, I used this round brush. And I got just regular old dollar store paint, brown paint, and then I started just banging on the paper with the brush. Oh, my brush is super wet. But it was dry. So I just banged and banged and banged, and I did the background. I put a little bit of white. And I just did a large surface area for my background. Then, after that, I started drawing with a pencil a light image of what I wanted to portray, which was a cube. So I went ahead and did my lines with the pencil, very lightly. I did my lines of the cube here in the back, and my sphere and the cone. And then I started with my colors. Well, the black. I started with the black. I did the line for the black under the cube, on the sides, in the back. And I wanted to do it really dark in the top part and the left side of the cube. But it didn't come out exactly as I wanted. It looked kind of, you know, not nice, kind of funny. So I eventually rubbed the black part off as much as I could with just a regular old rag. And I'm satisfied. It looks nice. I'm happier than what it looked like before, because the dark just didn't really do the trick. If you want, you could always do perfect cube for background, perfect, and do the measurements, use your rulers, and maybe it'd be a better image for you. So it's like I said, it's up to you. So then I did the spheres and the cone, the sphere and the cone, and I used the flat brush with my colors, which one was turquoise. So I had the turquoise color, and I went ahead and did the dark side, all the dark side. And you use your strokes. You make a full stroke in the back, and then you make semicircles, making two tiny circles to get to the center. I don't know if you understand that. It's a large, like that, and then you do strokes to get to the center, and then tiny strokes in the center. But the large full circle around, and do that. And then the opposite with the turquoise and the white to make the lights coming from this side. So lights coming this way. So this is the side where the lighter color will be. This is the light. So you do the same thing on the opposite side. You do your strokes the opposite direction, full, flat with the paintbrush. Full and smaller strokes to get to the center. Okay? Same thing for the cone. The cone, you go ahead and get your dark color, and you do the back part of the cone. And a cone has a circular bottom, so you do the circle, and you go up until you get to the tip. Vice, same way with the white. Only not as far. Don't go as far as you did with the dark. Go not as far and go like halfway at the halfway point. Pretend like it's just a regular triangle and imagine a line in the middle. Don't go too much past that imaginary line in your mind, because if you do, then, you know, light will be coming from here and here. But I in my mind, I want it only to come from this side. So go ahead and do like with an imaginary line in the middle of that cone, and I won't pass it. So go ahead. You can pass a little. Like I said, it's abstract art. There's no perfect and perfection. But then I did that. Then the shading in the back, I wanted to use stippling. I love to use stippling. And that, I used my toothbrush. Used the regular old toothbrush, black, and a little little bit of the turquoise color, and I went ahead and stippled the back part of the image, because that's the darker side. So I stippled over here the back part of the image, and got it just a little shaded and a little bit darker, and it created that effect of a shaded area. Then I went ahead and got my very, very thin paintbrush. Got my thin paintbrush, and I used it to do the line, the fine line, detailed line, to go the back, the front, around, and the sweep. And that's how I did my image. As you can see, it's abstract art. There's no perfection. Like I said, you might want red circle, cone, and cube. You might just want just circles and cube, and it's whatever. Whatever it is that you want to do. If you want something to look realistic, if you don't. You know, it is art. It's what you feel, and have fun, you know. Have fun doing your artwork. If your walls are, say your walls are turquoise, maybe you want turquoise and beige. If your walls are turquoise, maybe it'll be white and turquoise. Or maybe it'll be all the different tones of turquoise. A little bit of black with turquoise, a little bit of white with turquoise, and you'll have fun, and you might just frame it and say, yes, I love this. This is what I'm going to do with the final canvas. So just have fun, okay? Sorry about the images. I've been moving around the canvas. But I hope you get an idea of shading and, you know, some basic techniques that you could use. Okay? Have fun. Bye.